Green Willow Books, an imprint of HarperCollins Publishers and Harper Audio present Surely, Surely, Marisol Rainey by Erin Entrada Kelly, performed by Amielynn, Abellera. 2. Danny. Nice try, Marisol. Marisol Rainey keeps a list in her head. She calls it her list of favorites. Her favorite day of the week is Saturday. Favorite friend is Jada. Favorite food is lumpia. Favorite movie is A Dog's Life. Favorite ice cream is vanilla. Favorite animal is cats. Favorite snack is jelly beans. Favorite teacher is Miss Ruby, and her favorite color is green. Her best friend, Jada George, has a list, too. Marisol and Jada like to compare their lists because it's interesting to see all the ways they are the same and all the ways they are different. For example, Marisol's favorite ice cream flavor is vanilla, because vanilla goes with everything. You can use vanilla for banana splits, which is one of Marisol's favorite foods. You can pour chocolate syrup on top of vanilla. You can mix peanuts or sprinkles with vanilla. You can put vanilla on top of apple pies, brownies, and peach cobbler, and it always tastes delicious. Jada disagrees. She says vanilla is boring. She likes mint chocolate chip because it has tiny pieces of chocolate in it. Marisol's older brother, Osgood, everyone calls him Oz, says it's too hard to pick favorites when there are so many things to like. But Jada and Marisol don't think so. To them, their lists of favorites make perfect sense. Marisol and Jada also have lists of their least favorites. Lemon is Marisol's least favorite ice cream flavor. For Jada, it's butter pecan. Mustard is Marisol's least favorite condiment. For Jada, it's mayonnaise. Radishes are Marisol's least favorite food. For Jada, it's grapefruit. Marisol imagined her and Jada's least favorite foods talking to each other. The mayonnaise would say, "Jada may not like me, but I like me." The lemon ice cream offering to hug it out with the grapefruit. The butter pecan ice cream wondering, "Where did I go wrong?" And the mustard stating that it was just rude to have a least favorite. Marisol and Jada spend a lot of time discussing the things they like and don't like. Jada is a philosopher, so she thinks about stuff that no one else considers, which means she likes to ask questions, such as, "Would you rather?" "Would you rather eat radishes or drink mayonnaise for the rest of your life? Would you rather eat only nachos forever or never eat them again? Would you rather give up banana splits or jelly beans?" Jada also asks things like, "Would you rather clean Beans' litter box every day or clean your room?" Because she knows those are two of Marisol's least favorite things to do. Beans is Marisol's orange cat. Even though Jada and Marisol don't have identical lists, they both agree that their number one least favorite thing to do is gym class. Gym class at Getty Elementary School isn't always terrible. Sometimes Marisol has fun, like when they play hopscotch, and she likes Coach Decker. She doesn't like him as much as Miss Ruby. Miss Ruby is number one on her favorite teacher's list, but he's nice. Even though his face shrivels like a raisin when he's concentrating on his stopwatch, and his whistle is loud and shrill. Coach Decker shouts a lot, but not in a mean way. When Sherry Rote runs the bases, Coach Decker shouts, "Go, Sherry, go!" When Evie Smythe scores points in basketball, he shouts, "All right, go, Evie!" And when Danny Grant wins the shuttle runs, he says, "Way to go, Danny!" Marisol likes when Coach Decker cheers for her, even though she never runs the bases or scores points or wins races. But once, just once, she would like to hear him shout, "Way to go, Marisol!" just like he does for Sherry and Evie and Danny. Instead, Coach Decker would say, "Nice try, Marisol. Great effort, Marisol." But those weren't the same. Any other Thursday. Marisol's terrible Thursday starts like any other Thursday. She suffers through math. She listens during social studies. She does worksheets in science. Then it's time for recess. At recess, she plays food tag, which is one of her favorite games. It's like freeze tag, except you yell out the name of a food before you unfreeze someone, and it can't be a food that's already been said. Marisol loves playing food tag because she knows a lot of foods that her classmates don't. That's because her mother is from the Philippines, which means Marisol eats Filipino food that no one else has ever heard of, like lumpia, pancit, and chicken adobo. She loves lumpia so much that one of her five stuffed animal cats is named Lumpia. The others are banana split, pot roast, high C, and nacho. At first, it's a normal Thursday. Life is good. After Marisol wins food tag, she and Jada walk to gym class. It's free play day, which means they can do any activity they want. Jada and Marisol always choose hula hooping because they like to compete with each other. Some days, Marisol hula hoops the longest. Other days, it's Jada. Today, Marisol wins by 7 seconds. At the end of class, they are both exhausted. Hula hooping is harder than it looks. Then, Coach Decker gathers them all together and says the worst 5 words Marisol has heard all day. Surely the worst 5 words she's heard all week, maybe all year, possibly her entire life. "Next week, we start kickball!" Evie Smythe cheers. "Oh, I love kickball!" she says, adjusting her fox ears. Evie Smythe loves wearing fox ears to school. They look a lot like Marisol's cat ears, but Evie insists they are fox ears, not cat ears. Marisol doesn't wear her cat ears to school, but if she did, she would let everyone know that they were cat ears, not fox ears. "Good, because we'll spend 2 weeks on it," Coach Decker says. Marisol's belly plummets to her sneakers. She locks eyes with Jada, whose expression looks just like hers, not smiling and almost frowning. 2 whole weeks! Coach Decker tells them to tidy up the gym equipment, and Evie talks about kickball the whole time.
"I can kick the ball so far," Evie tells Danny Grant as she carries a paddle ball set to its plastic bin. "Practically from one side of the field to the other."
Marisol thinks that Evie talks to Danny because he's the shyest kid in class, which means he barely says anything, which means Evie gets to talk as much as she wants.
"I'm the best at kickball," Evie continues.
It isn't very nice for Evie to be so braggy, in Marisol's opinion. Then again, Marisol's also a little jealous. Evie is good at all sports. It isn't fair. When it's time to get in a single-file line, Marisol acts like she doesn't have a care in the world. But her heart goes thump, thump, thump. She barely even reacts when Jada taps her shoulder.
"Felix says he can talk to animals," Jada whispers.
Marisol doesn't turn around. They aren't supposed to talk in line. Besides, all she can think is, "Kickball, kickball, kickball," like a bright, blinking sign. Marisol has never played kickball before, but she already knows she won't be good at it. Sure, she can play hopscotch and tag, and she can hula hoop for a long time. She doesn't even mind taking part in a race sometimes at recess, especially if it's a skipping race. But kickball is a team sport. Everyone counts on you. If you mess up, you mess everything up. The spotlight shines on you when you kick. The spotlight shines on you when you pitch. The spotlight shines on you when you catch. The spotlight shines on you when you run the bases. Surely Marisol will burst into flames under all those spotlights.
Earth to Marisol. Earth to Marisol.
Jada whispers behind her.
Kickball.
Is all Marisol can say. She does not say it in a joyful voice. She does not say it in a cheerful voice.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.